Hey everyone, it's Bobby from Lyco Birds, and this is another video in my Bird ID Through the Year series, and this one's going to cover pigeons and doves. So for the most part, that is going to mean two species, both of which are pretty common, but also I wanted to say a few things about two other species. So let's jump in. And first up we have Mourning Dove. Now in terms of plumage, you're mostly looking at warm brown and gray tones. There's a little bit of black spotting on the upper side, and also it has a pale blue orbital ring. And in terms of the body shape, you have a pretty slender build, and also this long and pointed tail. And if we look at the tail, you can see this is the middle of the tail, and as you go outwards, you can see the tips of the tail feathers are shorter and shorter. So you end up with sort of this diamond shape almost, which is why the tail looks so pointed most of the time, because these outer tail feathers are so much shorter than the middle one. And the other species that you're also probably familiar with is rock pigeon. And if you're using eBird, you'll see these as rock pigeon, feral pigeon. And feral pigeon is basically referring to the fact that originally they were introduced to North America as domesticated birds, and then they escaped and returned to the wild. In terms of plumage, they are quite variable, but generally they are overall gray, often with iridescent greens and purples in the neck, and really you're looking at cold tones, in contrast to mourning dove, which was warm tones. They also typically will have a white cere, which is this part right here where the top of the bill meets like the forehead area. And the structure overall is bulky compared to mourning dove, and they have a shorter tail. And let's compare them in flight. So on the left here, you can see the mourning doves, and those warm tones are quite apparent in contrast to the cold tones of rock pigeons. And you can also see the slender build and the long and pointed tail on all of these examples. And you can see the tail is spread on these, but look how blunt the tip of the tail is in this example. So another difference will be in the actual flight style. Mourning doves have a flight style that is quite fast and fairly direct. And usually you'll hear an audible whistling in the wings as they go by you. And the wings typically are going to be angled back like this. And you'll also see the birds gently sort of rocking back and forth a little bit as they go by you. But overall, the thing is that they have this real sense of momentum as they zip right by you. They can also be a tad bit clumsy at times when they're coming into land. And one other thing to be aware of is that they do have a courtship flight that has deeper flaps, and then they go into sort of a turning glide. So just be on the lookout for that in the early spring as they're looking to nest. And for rock pigeon, the flight style is more reminiscent of a falcon. So compared to mourning dove, the flapping is definitely more powerful looking and conveys more of a sense of effort than mourning dove. But pigeons also will often glide with their wings sort of locked in a deep V like you see this bird doing. And overall, I would just say that they seem quite capable in the air, even if they don't seem particularly graceful about it. And here you can get an idea of the range of variation that you see in rock pigeons. So this photo in particular does a good job of showing this one and this one are fairly typical ones you see. They have gray wings with these black bars, and there's two of them. And that's going to be a typical form that you see. There's also these ones with more checkered pattern in the wings. And then there's these really dark ones. So these are the three that you'll see most often, but also you can see birds with any amount of white. You can see pure white, just a little bit of white mixed through the body, and also just a tiny bit of white in certain places. So just a very big range of variation. Again, that comes from the fact that they were domesticated when they were brought over here. So now we have all these different types. one other species to be on the lookout for, but is pretty rare in most of the Northeast, is Eurasian collared dove. And if you're really paying attention, you probably can figure out that these are also an introduced species in North America. They have spread out over much of the continent, although the Northeast is kind of the last holdout, and they are still quite rare in Pennsylvania. But you can see they have largely that overall dove look again, but they have this dark collar, and they also have very dark primaries. And remember, primaries are the outer flight feathers of the wing. But when these fly, they don't really strike me as very dove-like. They strike me a lot more like pigeons. And one other thing you may want to be careful with on these is looking in the undertail covered area to make sure that this is gray. African colored dove can escape from captivity, and those look very similar, but they would have white in the undertail coverts here. And finally, let's talk about passenger pigeon. Now, these are unfortunately extinct at this point, but I figured it was worth mentioning them in case you're looking through historical reports or something and see a reference to wild pigeons. And that, of course, is in contrast to rock pigeons, which were introduced. So you have the wild pigeons or the passenger pigeons. And we are lucky enough to actually have one on display at our local museum in Williamsport, which is the Tabor Museum. And this bird was collected in nearby Linden in 1890. So it was just a really cool experience to actually get to see one of these. And for those of you who know me, you know I am very much into the local birds in my area, specifically in Lycoming County. And I'm extremely interested in the history of birds and old sightings and whatnot. So this was really cool for me to actually get to see a passenger pigeon that was from my home county. And for those of you who don't know, Lyco Birds is actually named after our county, Lycoming County. And originally, we started Lyco Birds just as a way of documenting and giving information about the birds in our county. Now, of course, we've gone well beyond that at this point and cover a large range of areas, especially most of the Mid-Atlantic and Northeast. But yeah, that's just kind of going back to our roots a little bit. And I will wrap up there. I know this maybe isn't the most exciting topic in birding, but hopefully you got a few tidbits out of this. And next video, we'll be moving on to raptors, which I know is a very popular topic on our channel. So I hope you will join me there.